knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Kicking off our study of the deuterostomes, we will examine phylum Hemichordata. The hemichordates, along with the echinoderms, make up the clade Ambulacraria. All members of this clade share a three-part coelom and similar larval forms. Many of the hemichordates are worm-like in appearance. All known species are marine, and as adults, they live their lives on the ocean floor, often in shallow waters, while some species are found in abyssal zones where little to no light permeates. Their most diverse class, the acorn worms, are solitary deposit or filter feeders, though some are free-living detritivores that search the ocean floor for detritus. Most are sedentary and sessile as adults, meaning they seldom leave one location if they can help it. Though most of the acorn worms are solitary, some members of the class Pterobranchia are colonial, such as members of the genus Rhabdopleura, which can form encrusting colonies upon the substrate. The name hemichordate essentially means half-chordate, because the hemichordates share some but not all of the chordate characteristics. They were previously considered to be a subphylum of Chordata due to their possession of gill slits and their rudimentary notochord. However, more recent analyses discovered that the hemichordate notochord isn't actually a notochord at all. Though it is an internal skeletal system, it is derived from the evagination of the mouth cavity and isn't actually homologous to the chordate notochord. Instead of a subphylum of Chordata, they are now understood to be their own phylum and a sister clade to the echinoderms. Most species are cryptic and rarely seen, living in U-shaped burrows, but their casts are somewhat common on beaches around the world. In order to better study the hemichordates, let's go over their general characteristics, form and function, development, and finally, classification and diversity. Hemichordates generally have a body that is divided into the proboscis, collar, and trunk. Though some species superficially resemble earthworms, they are not actually closely related. They are free-living, bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, soft-bodied coelomates with complete digestive tracts, a hollow dorsal nerve cord, a three-part or tripartite coelom, and a filter-feeding system of gill slits that connect the pharynx to the outside environment. They also have a circulatory system of dorsal and ventral vessels and a dorsal heart. Most species range in size from 9 to 45 centimeters, or 3.5 to 17 inches, but the largest can reach lengths of 1.5 meters or more, so longer than 5 feet. The hemichordates have digestive, circulatory, respiratory, nervous, and reproductive systems. Most hemichordates are detritus feeders that take in large amounts of sand or mud and extract organic material, while others feed on organic matter suspended in the water. Their digestive system begins with their flexible, active proboscis that can probe surroundings and pushes food into the mouth cavity, which is ventral to the proboscis. The mouth empties into the buccal cavity and then pharynx, with a row of gill slits along either side. Material then moves into the esophagus, followed by the long intestine that extends for most of their body and ends at the anus where filtered casts pass. Hemichordates have an open circulatory system that works in conjunction with the excretory system, in which the blood flows through the tissue sinuses. A dorsal blood vessel delivers blood to a sinus within the proboscis that contains the dorsal heart, which is unique among animals because it does not connect directly to the blood system, but instead pulsates and indirectly pushes blood through the surrounding sinuses and into the glomerulus, which has an excretory function. Hemichordates are noted for their respiratory system that consists of a row of gill pores located on the trunk, directly behind the collar, which connect to a series of U-shaped gill slits on the side of the pharynx. Though they lack gills, gases can be exchanged within the chamber formed by the gill slits and along the body wall. The nervous system of the hemichordates consists of a plexus of nerves beneath the epidermis that is concentrated into both dorsal and ventral nerve cords, though the ventral nerve cord only reaches as far as the collar, while the dorsal nerve cord reaches into the proboscis and is often hollow. It is thought to be analogous to the chordate brain. The proboscis itself contains a sensory nerve layer and preoral organs that may be chemoreceptive, along with photoreceptive cells in some species. The hemichordate reproductive system consists of separate sexes with paired gonads that lie close to the pharynx and release gametes into the water column. The female lays a large number of eggs embedded in a gelatinous mass of mucus, which are then externally fertilized by the male before water currents break up the mass and disperse the individual eggs. Though some species of acorn worms appear to be able to reproduce asexually through fragmentation, most reproduce sexually. However, the acorn worms in particular are noted for their twin developmental strategies, which are direct and indirect and vary by species. The acorn worm Tychodera flava, for example, demonstrates indirect development where the young develop into tornaria larvae and survive through different stages as a filter feeder before developing into a juvenile and then adult. Sacoglossus kowalewskii, meanwhile, undergoes direct development where the late gastrula develops directly into a juvenile that grows into an adult. There are fewer than 200 described species of hemichordates, split into two classes with very different morphologies, Enteropneusta and Pterobranchia. Members of class Enteropneusta are commonly called acorn worms, and they were the main clade we have been discussing. Their bodies are generally long and slender and covered in mucus. Most are sessile, but deep-sea members of the family Torquaratoridae, like the extra-wide-lipped acorn worms, are able to crawl along the substrate. The general body plan of class Pterobranchia can vary widely, though most are usually small, around 1 to 7 millimeters, and live within colonies of secreted tubes that may or may not include long stalks. Cephalodiscus colonies, for example, vary greatly from Rhabdopleura colonies. They are all worm-like filter feeders that are often found in deep waters. And that covers the hemichordates. Let's move forward and introduce the sister phylum to Hemichordata, called Echinodermata.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.